Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/APOD. And today's picture for January the 3rd of 2020, well, it is titled Quadrantids Over the Great Wall. So what do we see here? Well, this is a part of the Quadrantid meteor shower, which will again be peaking this coming night. So January 3rd and 4th, in the early morning hours before sunrise, is a good chance to be able to see a few of these meteors moving through the sky. Now, meteor showers are named for their radiant point, the point from which the meteors appear to come. And if you trace them all back, and in this case up off the upper right portion of the image, they would all seem to come from the same portion of the sky. And that is named for the constellation that is in that part of the sky. And in this case, it is actually named for a constellation that is no longer an official constellation. It is the constellation of Quadrans Muralis. And that used to be a constellation of the Wall Quadrant, but is no longer one of the official 88 constellations recognized. So its name carries over because of the meteor shower that is associated with it. However, the constellation itself no longer exists. Now, just to clarify that, the stars, of course, still exist. Just the patterns of stars and the boundaries of the constellations that have been defined by the International Astronomical Union are different. And this was one of the constellations that was eliminated more than 100 years ago as astronomers tried to get definite patterns in the sky that everyone would use. So very good patterns that everyone would use to identify each part of the sky. So the way the constellations are defined now is different than how they were in the past. Now they are very specific areas of the sky with very distinct boundaries. So wherever you point in the sky, you will always be pointing to one of the constellations. Now, this meteor shower is also interesting because it is identified as coming from an asteroid. Often, meteor showers are seen to come from cometary material, which would be icy material and dusty material left behind as a comet passes close to the sun. The sun heats up that material and makes the comet visible by creating a great coma and tails that surround the comet and trail back from the comet. And then that material gets left behind and continues to orbit around the sun just as the comet did. However, when the Earth happens to pass through that, then it will pick up some of those materials. They will strike the Earth's atmosphere at very high speed and will be vaporized. So we do not get bombarded by these micrometeorites as someplace like, say, the moon would. But instead, we get the idea of a shooting star or a meteor traveling across the sky. On the moon, you would never see such a thing. So these are just little bits of debris left behind, generally by the orbit of a comet, but in this case, the orbit of a meteor. So material left behind, by an asteroid. So material left behind by an asteroid that then strikes the Earth's atmosphere and these tiny pieces burn up. So these never make it down to the ground to become meteorites. It takes much larger pieces to be able to get something to make it through the journey, complete the journey through the Earth's atmosphere, and make it down to the surface of the Earth. So here we get to see a little bit of that meteor shower. Again, a new one coming up again tonight. And as seen, framed with the Great Wall of China in the foreground. So that was our picture of the day for January the 3rd of 2020. It was titled Quadrantids Over the Great Wall. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.